Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. One of the leading causes of quarrels in homes is finances, and a lot of women are always like, how can I grow my finances? And most times we are thinking, oh, I need to make more money, which is true, but sometimes if you think of how much you can save and what you can do with what you have saved, then it's a lot. Okay, so we're just going to be looking at ideas and how you can save more money in 2022. All right, the first thing I wrote here is to have a positive mindset about money, to have a positive mindset about finances. I find out that a lot of women do not like to talk about the subject of money because somehow we've been raised, we've been trained not to talk about money. It's like, oh, money is a man's thing. Men are the ones that are supposed to talk about money. Like, that's not something women should talk about. Women should talk about makeup, women should talk about hair, women should talk about looking good, but women shouldn't talk about money. So somewhere in our subconscious, when the issue of money comes up, there's this defensiveness that some of us may have. So you want to have a positive mindset about money because you cannot run away from it. You need money to do practically everything. Yeah, people say, yes, the root, love of money is the root of evil. It's okay, we understand, but you need to still have that money to be able to be effective in whatever it is that you have to do. So having a positive mindset about money is the first foundation of everything. You need to have a positive mindset about money. So that's the first thing that I wrote. In having a positive mindset about money, you also want to focus on where you are right now. Like, I will always tell you guys that I'm a believer, and something that my pastor used to always say is that where you are right now is the best place to be. Now, it may not be fantastic, it may not be up to your own standard, but that's the best place to be because God works with what we have in our hands right now, where we are right now, because there's a lot of value right there where you are, even in that little corner, in that little space in the world. There's a lot of value in whatever it is that you are doing. So once you change your perspective from, oh, I don't have enough, I don't have, what I'm doing is not enough, once you change your perspective to, there's a lot of value with whatever I'm doing, whatever handwork that you are doing, whatever job that you are doing right now, even if that job you are not happy about the job, but once you change your perspective about what it is that you have, where you are right now, it gives you the opportunity to have a clear mind to begin to think about the future. Now, let me say this. I've created a video about how to create a digital vision board. I'm going to put the link somewhere. Please watch that video. It's really going to help you, okay, in developing a good positive mindset. The next thing I want to say is create the discipline of creating budgets. Yes, create that discipline of creating budget. Somebody may say, ah, Tokpe, you have come again. It's not like I even have plenty money. What am I creating budget for? Now, the thing is that whether you have 1 billion or you have 100 naira, you are spending money or something. There's a place that money is going to. There are things that you buy every month. There are things that you use every month. There are certain things that you have to do every month. You have to pay your light bill. You have to buy food in the house. You have to buy data. You have to buy recharge card. Now, you want to create a budget for doing that, and it doesn't have to be anything super complicated. Kuda app, there's an app called Kuda. They have a feature where you can create a budget, and it's so fantastic. I'm going to put it on the screen. All you need to do there is, this video is not sponsored, they not pay me to say this, but it's something that I've been using and it's very good. You can create a budget with Kuda app. It doesn't, if it's 1,000 naira something, put it there, but it gives you a bird's eye perspective of what it is that you need to buy. Also, in the same vein of creating the discipline of creating budgets, you also need to track your expenses. What are you spending money on? Sometimes if you track what you are spending money on, you will see that you have money. It's true. You see that you have money. If you track how much we spend on recharge cards and data, you will see that we're very rich. Once you just create that discipline of tracking your expenses and what, where your money is going, then you'll now know that, okay, maybe I need to cut down on spending on XYZ. Okay, maybe I need to, is this thing that I'm spending my money on, I'm not seeing the benefit of spending my money on this thing, so that maybe I need to change. So these two disciplines of creating budgets and also tracking your expenses, no matter how rich you are, even organizations, even corporate organizations, they do something called audits. Every year they are going to audit their accounts to know whether there's wastage, because wastage is the biggest thing on earth that steals our prosperity. There's just so much waste. If we look at how much we are wasting, and if you gather, you know, Jesus Christ, like I said, I'm a believer, so I will always refer to the Bible. Now, there's a story of in the Bible where Jesus fed 5,000 people. And after they fed the people, he told his disciples, gather the remaining. And those remaining were still a lot. So most times, we are wasting things. We are wasting skills. We are wasting talent. We are wasting a lot of things that are just lying dormant because we have not audited our lives. Because we've not audited what it is that we are doing, we really do not have a perspective of the things that we are wasting. So what I'm trying to say is that track your expenses, create budgets. Don't just go into a supermarket as the spirit leads, you just begin to buy. No, track it. There are some people in my personal life that may not like me because, and I'm coming to my other point, you don't have to buy everything. You don't have to please everybody. Some of us, the thing that is dragging our money is because you want people to like you. If you want people to like you, go and be selling ice cream. I will always tell people, you don't have to like me. But you see that respect? You must respect me. I don't care whether you like me. Anybody that knows me knows that this is how I've been. So stop trying to please people. If you cannot afford it, you cannot afford it. Why are you entering inside gbese? Because you want to make another person happy. If you want to show somebody you love them, you want to do go for a wedding, must you buy the ashoebi if you cannot afford it right now? You not get. You not cost person. It's not a crime not to have. But I see a lot of people getting into unnecessary debts, trying to please A, trying to please B. Stop it in 2022. Okay, stop it. Stop putting your husband under undue pressure. Okay? Okay. So I put here, you don't have to buy everything. Not go there, do pass yourself. Let me speak pidgin. Do as your hand reach you. If you cannot buy human hair right now, it's okay. Do the one that you can do. See, too many ladies, too many women now are having high blood pressure because I want to be like the next person. I want to compete with this one. Stop it. Stop doing competition. You need to plan for your children. Those are the things that are important to you. Think of their future. Forget all these things. The clothes that you wear this year, next year, it will not be in vogue. So what is the problem? Why are we now disturbing ourselves like this? Take your time, mom. Let me go to my next point. I said focus on gaining assets and not liabilities. Think of how you can begin to build assets. It's a mindset. That's why I said you need to create a positive mindset. It doesn't matter how much you have right now. But as you begin to think about it, like I said, go and watch my video on creating a vision board. Oh, I want to buy property. My mom is my greatest mentor. My mom, she will say, she will save to buy property. She will save to do things that are worthwhile. So many of us, we don't use money when you take buy land, take buy bag, buy shoe. Money that you will use to build something that your children will keep calling you blessed for the rest of your life. That, my mother did this for me. I'm not talking about what your father did, what your mother did for you. How many of us now can say that when our children are going to university or they will have something to say that this is what my mother did for me? No, we are using it to do ashebi. We are using it to do things that in the next 10, 15 years, nobody will care Seriously. So focus on creating assets. Someone says, okay, talk about, I don't have money. Open accounts for your children. Open accounts for yourself that you are saying, okay, I am putting aside, even if it's 1,000 naira, there's piggy vest. You can begin to save with piggy vest that, okay, I'm putting aside this to start developing assets. It's not only your husband that should have assets. You yourself have assets. Have assets in your own name. Yes, that I bought this land in my name. I bought this thing in my name. I'm not saying you and your husband will not, but you as a woman, so you should have your own. So that way you can save money is if you have, what is it called? Prepaid meter. Put up things that you are not using. Okay, sometimes you'll be wondering, I just spend money. You are not using AC in one room. Off it, put it off. Train your children to put off lights. When power, save energy, because you are spending a lot of money on energy, on power. I know that some of us don't have prepaid meters, but if you have prepaid meters, put anything you are not using. Sometimes just put off your freezer. It's already blocked. Put it off because you will only pay for what you make use of. Another thing I would say is that buy foodstuff in bulk. If you can, go to farmers market. Things are usually cheaper in farmers market. Buy things in bulk, blend the tomatoes, cook it, put it in the freezer. I know that sometimes in Nigeria, yes, it may be hard because of light situation, but there are some things that you can buy in bulk that it's not every day you'll be going to the street to buy. Do you understand? It will really, really reduce your expenses and you can plan ahead. Then I also wrote down here, buy quality stuff. If you want to spend money on buying anything, buy a good bag that you know that you can carry that bag for a long time. But anywhere you go, even if it's two you have, you know that it's quality. If you are buying clothes, buy quality clothes that even if you know you don't have a lot, but let the one that you have use it well, okay? So that you if you buy quality, you can use it for a long time. As God begins to bless you, as God prospers your hair, you can begin to enter streets. I'm going to end this video here. These are ways that you can, easy ways to save money as a housewife. And as you are saving the money, be thinking of how you can expand your income. Think of other things. Think of your gifts. Think of your talents. Think of something that you are not using currently and how you can make use of it and begin to earn on it, okay? Because inside your house right now, there's a lot of value to be extracted.